Two of my favorite things are Philly sports and music, and that's the same with this guy, a former co-worker of mine back in the 1980s, and something of a New Jersey radio legend. These days, among other things, he does a popular weekend show called Springsteen on Sunday on 107.1 The Boss. We say hello to Tom Cunningham. Hey, TC.
Hey, Jim.
You and I worked together back in the day at WPST. Now, other than our radio station team beating Bon Jovi and their crew in a 1984 softball game at Ryder College, what do you remember most from your years at PST?
Oh, boy. You know, to be on that station basically every day of the 80s. I started there in 79 and left there in 89. Anyone who halfway pays attention to popular music and popular culture knows the significance of the music of the 80s and the movies of the 80s and how they came together to form this perfect storm of art. And to be on that station, that was a massive radio station. I don't know that at the time we really knew exactly how massive that was. And to have that smack in the middle of the dial, 97.5, 50,000 watts, and just a blowtorch of a signal that went everywhere, it was one of the great times of my life, absolutely.
Helped launch Bon Jovi's Hall of Fame career back in 84. But tell me about you and the Bruce Springsteen connection. How did that begin for you personally, and how did you end up doing a weekly show focusing on Bruce and his music 16 or so years back?
Well, I was 16 in 73 when Greetings from Asbury Park, New Jersey came out. My radio station of choice was 93.3 WMMR. Just enamored with the music of that era. I had quickly made the shift from AM Top 40 to progressive FM, man, in 68 when the Marconi experiment started, you know, that whole thing on MMR. Ed Shockey was my guy. David Dye was my guy. Michael Pearson was my guy. You know, they famously championed Bruce. Bruce broke off of WMMR. Spirits and the night. Took a while, but without MMR support and those first two albums, you know, Bruce really would not have had the early career that he had. So I don't know what song I heard first come out of my radio, probably Blinded by the Light or For You or Spirit in the Night, one of those. I was all in. 1973, New Jersey. Nobody gave a flying whatever about New Jersey in 73. It was a joke. Here was this guy who grew up in Freehold, who loved hanging at the shore. I mean, these were things that we did. This was our lives at the time. And here was this guy embracing this part of what we loved. I mean, who didn't love the shore? And it all came together, especially on those first two albums. That was it. I was in with both feet.
Hey, I didn't see Bruce until the Born in the USA tour. Shame on me. What was your very first Bruce concert?
74 at the War Memorial in Trenton.
Wow.
I can close my eyes and still be in that room. It was that vivid. And, you know, now, of course, social media days, now I know the guy who promoted that show. and the other 800 people, because, you know, that was not a sold-out show. I had tried to see him at a place called Fat City in Seaside, Labor Day weekend of 73. Drinking age was 18 at the time. I had the world's worst fake ID, and I was 17. And the guy at the door, it was a motorcycle's driver's license. A, I had no motorcycle. And B, the guy at the door at this place was clearly like this motorcycle dude. And he would have none of my fake ID. But, you know, I grew up in Trenton, him coming to Trenton. This was like literally 2 weeks before I graduated from high school in 74. So what a way to wrap up my high school career. And I've seen him quite a few times in quite a few different places. So what a great ride.
Yeah, and now you've been doing this weekly show. It's currently on 107.1 The Boss. Springsteen on Sunday. You often have cool guests on there, by the way, including members of the E Street Band or Southside Johnny, my old pal Willie Nile. Where can people find Springsteen on Sunday?
On 107.1 The Boss, as you just said. Yeah, it's on Sunday mornings from 9 to 11. A new Sunday morning address for me. It was at my old location for the better part of 16 years. And, you know, you make a business decision or two as life unfolds. I don't like change. I hate change. especially after that long a period of time. But sometimes business happens, and I'm really enamored with this crew here at 107 on the Boss. They've made me feel at home right away. Yeah, I'm doing the same old thing on a different channel and the same time and the same thing, Jim. Can't beat it.
Excellent. Now, before I let you go, we're going to play a quick game of Fast Five. Keep your answers brief, and you're going to do well in this, I promise. All right, here we go. Number one, Tom, excluding the two World Series titles, give me a favorite Phillies baseball memory.
Well, I got to go 93 pennant clincher. My father always had season tickets for the Phils. He did not have a ticket for that game that night. To be able to, A, take my father to that game, and B, watch that game with him is something I'll never forget.
I was there sitting in left field. I remember it well. All right, number two.
700 level, baby.
There you go. You're a longtime Philly Eagles fan. Do you have a favorite Eagles player?
Well, oh, man. Like trying to pick one of your kids. How do you not say Reggie White? I mean, I could say Brian Dawkins really easily. How do you not say Reggie White?
Yep, can't go wrong there. Number three, name a band or artist that you have never gotten to see but you wish you had, and you can't say the Beatles.
Well, that's my answer.
Too easy.
You know what? I've seen them all, except the Beatles. So there.
Well, you're a lucky man. Number four, you alluded to having been there a lot. I don't know if you know the exact number, but how many Bruce concerts have you been to, do you think?
I would say somewhere right around. Now, I would include like club appearances and you know, all those
sure.
all those kind of things.
Yeah.
I would say like around 280.
Wow. All right. And finally, Tom, this is going to be tough, but give me your top three favorite Bruce songs.
Oh, man. Well, number one's always Incident on 57th Street.
Spanish Johnny drove in from the underworld last night.
I mean, that will always be number one. Thunder Road always has to be number two. And in a pinch, I guess would say Spirit of the Night would be number three.
Well, as I knew it would be, this was loads of fun. Thank you, Tom Cunningham.
Thank you, Jim Chesko. Rock on.